Ladies and gentlemen, we are ready for the co-feature of the evening. For the vacant Super Welterweight Fedicaribe Championship of the World Boxing Association. First, coming to the ring. From United States, Cleotis Mookie Pendarvis.
And here he comes from Los Angeles, California, born on June 22nd, 1986. He's 34 years old. He has a professional record of 21 victories, 9 by knockout, 5 defeats, and 2 draws. Yesterday, he weighed 153 pounds at the scales. And as we were saying before, in his last fight on March of last year, he was stopped by Ukrainian Sergei Bochechuk. But also remember, he defeated Puerto Rican Hector Sanchez as his most successful win, and also reached a world title eliminator against Derry Jean. This is Cleotis Mookie Pendarvis.
And now, coming to the ring, from Argentina, Francisco Emanuel Torres.
Born on October the 6th, 1989 in San Martin, Buenos Aires, but based in West Palm Beach, Florida, training in Fort Lauderdale. He's the number 13 of the WBC World Middleweight Ranking, and he's the current Argentinian middleweight champion, with a record of 14-3 with 5 knockouts. And in his last fight on December, he scored a 4th round TKO against Argentinian Sergio Paisé. He now has come to the ring for his US debut with 152.8 pounds, Francisco Emanuel Torres.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the co-feature of the evening, brought to you by Christy Marty Promotions and Payne Boxing Series, sanctioned by the Florida Boxing Commission. 8 rounds of boxing in the super welterweight division for the vacant super welterweight Fedicaribe Championship of the World Boxing Association, President Gilberto Jesus Mendoza. The judges doing the scoring for this contest are Brian Gary, Eric Larson, and Tina Griffith. The man in charge, Mr. Telis Asimenios. Introducing first, in the blue corner, weighing tonight 153 pounds, with a professional record of 21 victories, 9 by knockout, 5 defeats, and 2 draws. From Los Angeles, California, Cleotis Mookie Pendarvis. And now, introducing in the red corner, weighing tonight 152.8 pounds, with a professional record of 14 victories, 5 by knockout, and 3 defeats. From San Martin, Buenos Aires, Argentina, Francisco Emanuel Torres.
We expect a very competitive fight tonight with Emanuel Torres, that's the name he uses more than Francisco, and Cleotis Mookie Pendarvis for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title. Ronald Gibson, the corner in chief for Pendarvis, and Luis Perez for Emanuel Torres. The referee for this match, for this bout, Teles Asimeños, designated by the Florida State Commission. And the bell rings, and this is the first round of this fight to 8 rounds or less. Francisco Emanuel Torres against Cleotis Pendarvis. Torres, higher, taller. 6 foot Torres, 5 foot seven is Pendarvis. Torres taking the initiative, moving forward, using his left jab. Pendarvis waiting to counterpunch. Again with the left jab by Torres. 30 seconds of the first round. Good right cross by the Argentinian champion. Remember, tonight he is fighting in the super welterweight division. He's the current Argentinian middleweight champion. And he's the number 13 of the WBC world ranking. 50 seconds have already passed. Torres again, moving forward, trying to take the initiative. Always with his jab. With his jab, followed by his right cross. Pendarvis is waiting. Another jab to the face by Torres. Pendarvis still waiting, trying to counterpunch. His right cross is left in the air. 1 minute and 45 seconds to go of this first round. Torres, good cross, but lacked of power. Another cross, lacking of power by Torres, who's still the one taking the initiative. Trying to put on a show in his US pro debut. Good movement backwards, avoiding every attempt of counterpunch by Pendarvis. Torres dominating every movement of this 1 minute and 40 seconds that have already passed of this first period. We are at the Ocean Center in Daytona Beach. This is Payne Boxing Series live on TYC Sports and TYC Sports Play. Asimeños separates the boxers. Again, Torres trying to take the initiative. Pendarvis is a bit more covered, waiting for him, trying to respond to counterpunch. 50 seconds to go of the first round. Few actions so far. They are both studying each other. Pendarvis knows exactly what it means to face top boxers. He's his first test for Torres in US soil. Good right cross, followed by the left one by Emanuel Torres. 25 seconds to go of the first round. They almost tripped between each other. 18 seconds. Watch your head, said the referee Asimeños. 15 seconds now to go. Pendarvis' right hand is left in the air. 10 seconds now to go. Both studying each other at the end of the first round. And that's the end of the first 3 minutes of action for this bout for the WBA Super Welterweight title. 10 points for Torres, 9 for Pendarvis. Why? Because he landed the best punches so far. Few, of course. But with his longer arms, with a better reach, he used his jab wisely and managed to find the angles to land his right cross. 10 for this man, for Emanuel Torres. 9 for this man, for Cleotis Pendarvis. Asimeños is asking Torres' corner to not to use that amount of water. Second round has started. Both now trading punches, trading jabs. Torres is the longest one. Good right cross to the chin by Emanuel Torres. Again, putting pressure and trying to inflict damage with his left jab. Good right cross again. This time to the forehead of Pendarvis, who's much smaller than Torres. combination to the body. A bit more aggressive, Torres in this second round, as well as Pendarvis, who's trying to move forward the trade and go into the clinch. The jabs go by Torres with the left, marking his position. 1 minute has already passed of the second round. That right hand ends in the guard of Pendarvis. Good blocking by the Californian fighter. The clinch. This is TYC Sports. TYC Sports play at the opening show of Payne Boxing Series live from the Ocean Center in Daytona Beach in Florida for the whole world. 1 minute and a half of the second round remaining. Torres, always the one taking the initiative. Good answer by Pendarvis with his left cross. And now it's Torres, the one getting a bit damaged by Pendarvis. Good body work by the Californian fighter. The most aggressive movement so far by Mookie Pendarvis. 1 minute to go till the end of the second round. And again, regaining control, Torres with his long arms. Good movement, avoiding the attack of the Californian fighter. 50 seconds to go of the second round. A round where we have seen a bit more action. And there's a cut already. An injury on Torres's forehead on the left side. It shouldn't be much trouble for him and for his corner to contain the blood. Good cross and an excellent answer by Pendarvis. Pendarvis is answering now every single attack by Torres. And Torres is getting too much in the short distance. That's the most interesting way to fight for Pendarvis, who's of course much smaller. The round is about to end. Again, good jab by Torres, finishing with authority. And there goes the end of the second round in the Super Welterweight division for the WBA Fedicaribe title. Although Pendarvis managed to connect a few punches, again we give the round to Emanuel Torres, who dominated, who marked the path with that kind of movement, especially every time from the middle and long distance, combining his jab and his right cross, he connected the more clear punches. 10-9, and we have an extra official card of 2018 for the San Martin Buenos Aires born Emanuel Torres. Seconds out, and that's the beginning of the third round. Emanuel Torres fighting Cleotis Pendarvis for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title. This crown is vacant. The jab again goes by Torres, trying to follow it with the right cross. Pendarvis is waiting. He's not as tall as Torres. 6 foot, Torres. 5 foot seven for Pendarvis. Again in the clinch. Pendarvis with a good reaction. And Torres responds with his right cross. The jab again by Torres, always trying to mark the distance, trying to take advantage of his longer reach. Let him go, says the referee, Teles Asimenios. 50 seconds of the third round. We are at the Ocean Center in Daytona Beach in Florida with the opening show of Payne Boxing Series. After this, Alberto Palmeta will face Trash and Wiggins for the WBA International Welterweight title. Torres again with a jab. Pendarvis and a good hook to the body by Torres. Don't hold, says the referee Asimenios. 1 minute and 34 seconds to go of the third round. Torres not as aggressive as the first and second round. and now he connects the right cross. They're telling Emanuel Torres not to go to his right side, to go to the left. Again, Torres with the body work, with the right hand. Box, says the referee, Asimenios. Excellent movement and excellent right uppercut by Torres. The clearest punch of the fight so far. Well received, of course, by Pendarvis. Another uppercut with the right hand again by Torres. He's waiting for Pendarvis. He's inviting Pendarvis to move forward and he wants to receive him with the right uppercut. Now Pendarvis is also attacking to the body with his right hook. 30 seconds to go. 25 seconds now to go of the third round. Pendarvis lands a right cross. And now the left jabs by Torres, followed by the uppercut. Torres again, good movement. He now goes to the left side, as his corner said. We're about to end the third round, and there's the bell. The third round is history for the WBA Super Welterweight Fedicaribe title. Emanuel Torres from Argentina, Cleotis Pendarvis from Los Angeles. Again, another round slightly dominated by the Argentinian. Every time that he used his jab, followed by his right cross, but also connecting his right uppercut. 10 for Torres, 9 for Pendarvis. Extra official card for us. We have 30 for Torres, 27 for this man, for the experienced Cleotis Muki Pendarvis. We are entering the fourth round of this fight that goes to 8 rounds or less for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title. Emanuel Torres against Cleotis Pendarvis. Torres again in the center of the action, trying to move forward. His right hand goes to the body. Again, insisting with the right hand to the body. Again, third time in a row. They are not hard punches, but of course, he's summing points. 30 seconds have passed of this fourth round. Torres in a calm way trying to dominate the path of the fight. Pendarvis is a bit more explosive, but of course he has difficulties with Torres' size and especially with the reach of the Argentinian fighter. That's why Torres uses his jab again and his body work. The right hand again to the body and to the cheek by Torres in way of hook and cross. Good footwork by Torres, avoiding Pendarvis' attacks. 1 minute and 10 seconds have already passed of the fourth round. Let go, says the referee Asimenios. Again, Torres marking the distance with his left jab. Pendarvis trying to shorten it, trying to block the jab to get to the short distance. And again, the clinch. They grab themselves, but they can work still in the short distance. Torres fails with that uppercut. Pendarvis attacks. He connected slightly the right cross. 1 minute and 15 seconds to go. Torres combining to the body. Now again to the body, ending with the right cross to the cheek. Good movement by Torres now, moving towards the left side and the right side of Pendarvis' defense. 1 minute to go for the fourth round to end. Torres moving, waiting, trying to counterpunch. He feels comfortable in that way. That's the way we're used to Torres fighting in Argentina. But he promised to be a bit more aggressive. Let's see whether he can show it. 35 seconds to go, trading jabs. More aggression now by Torres with his right cross. 30 seconds to go. He receives a cross to his face by Pendarvis. Again, the right cross by Torres. He has dominated the whole fourth round, almost from bell to at least the bell that's about to ring. Now he's moving. He avoids this attack. Jab by Torres. Good body work. And that's the end of the fourth round at the Ocean Center in Daytona Beach in Florida. The opening show of Payne Boxing Series live on TYC Sports and TYC Sports Play. Emanuel Torres again using his reach, but also fighting in the short distance and connecting to the body, to the ribs. Gets the round 10-9 for Torres. Extra officially, we have 40-36 against Cleotis Muki Pendarvis. Tell us where you are tuning in. Where are you from? Greetings from Tram Lake, Syria. Also, people from Marble Falls, West Palm, York, Youngstown. Please tell us where you are tuning in from. To the Payne Boxing Series opening show live on TYC Sports, TYC Sports Play. Fifth round has already begun. Both fighters treading the center of the ring. Torres a bit more aggressive, connecting his right hand. Pendarvis waiting, studying Torres. Moving his head, trying to find the angle to connect his powerful left cross. But meanwhile, Torres insists. Left jab, right cross. Again. Left jab. But never came the right cross. 40 seconds have already passed of the fifth round. Pendarvis moves forward. He has an injury. A bit of blood dropping from his right eye. The Californian fighter. Torres is waiting for Pendarvis to move forward to counterpunch again with his uppercut. 1 minute has already passed of the fifth round. This is Emanuel Torres against Cleotis Pendarvis for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title. Torres again tries but fails with both hands. Pendarvis with good footwork. And Torres connects his hooks. Torres goes backwards. The right and left hook by Emanuel Torres. And now the jab. Footwork by Emanuel Torres. He moves towards his left as his corner told him. Now he stays in the ropes. Now he moves again to the left. Pendarvis is going after him. Again, the left jab. The key punch so far of this fight for Emanuel Torres, because with it he's always marking the distance. 1 minute to go of the fifth round. A good cross by Pendarvis, but not as precise as he would have wanted. The jab again by Torres. Left jab and moving to his left side. Pendarvis is chasing him. 40 seconds to go of the fifth round at the Ocean Center in Daytona Beach in Florida. Payne Boxing Series live on TYC Sports and TYC Sports Play. Torres again insisting with a left jab. And Pendarvis might feel it's impossible to enter to the short distance due to Torres' reach. Less than 10 seconds to go of the fifth round. Good body work by Torres with a hook. He remains in the ropes now. Good defense now by Torres. And that's the end of round number 5. We'll be right back. ranking, of course. 50 for Torres, 45 for Pendarvis. Round number 6. This fight goes to 8 or less for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title. Tell us where you are watching us from. We had lots of people supporting Charleston Poe that was defeated in the first round. Lots of people also supporting Treshen Wiggins, who faces Alberto Palmeta in the following and main event fight of the evening. This is TYC Sports and TYC Sports to the whole continent. Good movement again by Torres, combining up and down, head and body, and moving always to his left, exactly as his corner told him. Pendarvis manages to connect her right hand, but he receives 3 by Torres. Torres again with the jab, always straight, always marking the distance. And a wonderful uppercut with the right hand by Torres directly to Pendarvis' cheek. Jab again. They trade jabs, but the only one reaching is Torres, of course. Not only Torres is tall for this division, but also he has really long arms. And against Pendarvis, he's taking a lot of advantage with it. His right hand to the body, to the ribs. The damage inflicted is not as powerful as other kind, other style of boxers, but he gets the job done. Jabs traded. Torres faster with the right cross. Now he's trying to be a bit more aggressive, inviting Pendarvis. He goes forward. He fails with that right cross. Again with a left jab by Torres. 43 seconds to go from Daytona Beach at the Ocean Center. TYC Sports, TYC Sports Play with Payne Boxing Series. Remember, on our main event, we're going to have the following fight: Alberto Palmeta against Treshen Wiggins for the WBA International Welterweight title. 20 seconds to go. Torres again with a jab. 15 seconds to go, and Pendarvis moves a lot, but he's unable to connect firmly on Torres' body. Let's go. Let go, says Asimeños. And that's the end of round number 6 between Francisco Emanuel Torres, the number 13 of the WBC World Middleweight Ranking, against Cleotis Pendarvis. And once again, we have the round won clearly by Torres, who dominated from bell to bell, taking good advantage of his reach with his jabs, and once again, his uppercuts and his right crosses to the head. 60 for Torres, 54 for Pendarvis. Round number 7 for this fight for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title. And again, Torres first with the jab and once again with the right cross. That's his main job in the middle distance. He points and he marks the distance with a jab followed by the right cross. Now trying to the body. He's taller, he's longer than Pendarvis, and in that way he dominates him. Again, the right cross by Torres, the uppercut. Now he moves to the left side. Good hook to the body, to the stomach. Torres is getting more and more comfortable, more and more calm, and getting more advantage. For us, unofficially, of course, we have seen Torres win every single round so far of the fight. Pendarvis is trying unsuccessfully to respond with his left crosses. Good right hook to the body by Torres. And now the right cross again to the jaw. Torres is faster than Pendarvis. He's taller. He has longer arms and he connects better. 1 minute and 40 seconds left of round number seven. Pendarvis moving forward. Torres avoids the attack. Jab again by Torres. Uppercut by Torres. The jab, and he moves again to his left. Pay attention to that. Torres, from round number two onwards, has always moved to the left side of his attack. Always to the right side of Pendarvis' defense. After his coach, Luis Perez, shouted out, "Move to your left, not to your right." And Torres has always done that, and of course he has been very successful with it. 1 minute to go of round number seven. Torres with the jab and the cross directly to the jaw. Good defense by Emanuel Torres, by the Argentinian champion, against the experienced Californian Pendarvis. 40 seconds to go. Pendarvis doesn't even reach Torres from that angle. 30 seconds to go of round number seven. The jab gets first by Torres. Another jab by Torres. Pendarvis only stretches his arm, but he never reaches him. And a great cross by Emanuel Torres. 10 seconds to go of round number seven. Everything in control of the Buenos Aires-born Emanuel Torres, based now in West Palm Beach, Florida. And that's the end of round number seven. Another round in total control of Francisco Emanuel Torres, the number 13 of the WBC World Middleweight Ranking, tonight fighting in super welterweight division for the first time in his career and for the WBA Fedicaribe title. 70 for Torres, 63 for Pendarvis for this kind of attack. Even in the short distance, Torres is always more accurate, more precise, and he manages to control every single action. We receive greetings from Alexis, Matt, Tiz, Lex. Please tell us where you were tuning us from. All over the world, we have already received messages from Germany, England, every single part of the USA, Central America. Greetings also from Toronto, from Canada. Last round of the fight. 15 seconds have already gone through. Asimenios tells both to separate. Greetings also from Atlanta, Georgia, and from New York, New York. Also greetings from Newburgh, New York. They must be with Trash and Wiggins. Torres again in control, combining his left jab and his right cross, moving backwards, avoiding the answers by Pendarvis. Good footwork by Emanuel Torres. No punches by the Californian fighter. The right cross to the body. The swing to the body, actually, by Torres. Torres knows he has everything under control. It's Pendarvis' responsibility to try to change the path of this fight. Again, Torres moving to his left. He knows that there he has a good business to work with. The jab, the right cross, once again by Torres. Another jab and another right cross. Pendarvis leaves his punches in the air because of Torres' footwork. Everything under control of the Argentinian fighter, as it has been almost the whole fight so far. This is Torres' first fight in the US against the experienced Pendarvis. Good movement again by Torres, avoiding the attack by Mookie Pendarvis. Asimeno separates them again. The left hook to the body and now to the head by Torres, who moves now to the left and towards the ropes. He feels comfortable. He knows he has everything under control. Now he grabs Pendarvis. He's now playing with the time. He knows the fight is in his pocket. Now he moves from rope to rope, grabs Pendarvis. Asimenius tells him to let him go. The fight is about to end. If nothing strange happens, this will be a victory by Emanuel Torres in his first fight in the US, and that's the end. That's the end of round number 8, and that's the end of the fight. Francisco Emanuel Torres, for us at least, has defeated widely Cleotis Mookie Pendarvis for the WBA Fedicaribe Super Welterweight vacant title for this kind of movements. Oh, starting with his left jab, but also combining the right crosses in the middle distance, the right crosses in the short distance, and the uppercut, plus the hooks. Everything has been under control of the Argentinian fighter. For us, another round for him, 10-9, and we have an extra official card of 80-72. Now we are waiting for the decision by Brian Gary, Eric Lawson, and Tina Griffith, the three judges designated for this fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the co-feature of the evening, after 8 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecard. Judge Gary score about 79-73. Judge Larson scored 78-74. And Judge Griffith, he saw a score about 79-73. For the winner, by unanimous decision, and new Super Welterweight Fedicaribe champion of the WBA, from San Martín, Buenos Aires, Argentina, Francisco Manu Torres.
As it was expected, Francisco Emanuel Torres, in his first fight in US soil, takes his belt, the Fedicaribe Super Welterweight title, with scorecards of 79-73 twice and 78-74. All for the winner by unanimous decision, Emanuel Torres, the number 13 of the WBC middleweight ranking, that will for sure go down in the ranking to the super welterweight division. Francisco Emanuel Torres is now the champion.
Let's hear the word of the new Super Welter Fedicaribe WBA champion, Francisco Emanuel Torres. We will ask him first about the key of this fight. Manu, felicidades en vivo para Teis Sports. Título merecido. La clave de esta pelea para la victoria.
Hola, muchas gracias por todo. A lo que me siguen, muchas gracias desde mi casa. No, a ver, es un boxeador americano, tiene un boxeo que a mí me gusta. Bueno, era mantener la distancia, meter los rectos e intentar meter los cruzados, girar y demás. Obviamente que uno siempre planea las cosas, a veces sale, a veces no salen, pero creo que pudimos hacer lo que habíamos pensado.
Okay. He really admires the boxing, the American style boxing of Pendarvis, and he said that sometimes things go planning something about the way that he saw the fight didn't, but this time things go exactly like they prepare. Now we will ask him about the meaning of this title.
El significado de este título Fedecaribe para tu carrera, Manu.
No, la verdad que es algo muy importante, es un paso más que estamos haciendo. Y a ver, es increíble, yo siempre miraba esto cuando era chico y ahora estoy acá. Y creo que es un buen paso para seguir avanzando, también es motivador. Así que espero seguir acá y seguir creciendo.
Thank you. An important and motivating step in the career of Torres, the victory of tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the news. Super Walter, Fedecaribe champion, Francisco Manu Torres.